Before 1834, the year the refrigerator was invented, food preservation consisted of simple methods like salting, spicing, smoking, pickling, and drying. Of course, as we know now, none of those methods came close to competing with the refrigerator. But how does a refrigerator work? Simply put, your refrigerator has one job, which is to keep the inside cold. And it accomplishes this by collecting heat from the inside of the refrigerator and releasing it outside. When it comes to understanding how a refrigerator works, there are five main components to consider: the evaporator coil, the condenser coil, the expansion valve, the compressor, and a refrigerant. Inside the refrigerator, the evaporator coil is in charge of collecting heat, and the condenser coil located on the outside is in charge of getting rid of it. These two components are connected to each other using what's called a suction line and a liquid line. A chemical called a refrigerant flows through the system, and it's actually this fluid that is responsible for collecting the heat inside a refrigerator and transferring it out. By manipulating the properties of this fluid through the different stages of the cycle, we are able to move heat from one spot to the other. The expansion valve will allow us to decrease the pressure of the fluid, while the compressor will be in charge of increasing the pressure of the fluid. Before we get started, it's important to understand that hot always wants to move towards cold. For example, if you've ever been told during a hot summer day, "Hey kid, shut the door, you're letting all the cold air out." What you should have been told is, "Hey kid, shut the door, you're letting all the hot air in." Because hot always moves towards cold. So let's go over this again. So we have a coil inside our box called the evaporator coil, and one outside the box called the condenser coil. These two coils are connected using the suction line and liquid line. Flowing through the system is a fluid called a refrigerant. One important property for any refrigerant is to have a very low boiling point. R22, a common refrigerant, begins to boil at negative 40 Celsius. Yes, this fluid begins to boil at a really cold temperature. Let's start at the compressor. At this point, the fluid is in a low pressure gas phase. The gas then enters the compressor and is compressed, which increases the pressure. The gas leaves the compressor at a higher pressure than when it first entered. The now high pressure, high temp gas flows towards the condenser coil. At the condenser coil stage, the gas begins to lose heat to the surrounding atmosphere, probably your kitchen. This is because the temperature of the gas is much hotter than the temperature of the air in the kitchen. By the time it leaves the condenser coil, the fluid has lost enough heat that it cools and turns into a liquid. The fluid, which is now a liquid, makes its way towards the expansion valve, which it enters as a high-pressure liquid. The expansion valve expands the liquid, which causes a sudden drop in pressure. Now the fluid leaves the expansion valve as a low-pressure, low-temperature liquid, and makes its way towards the evaporator coil. As it passes through the evaporator coil, it picks up heat from inside the box, which once again turns it into a gas. The fluid leaves the evaporator coil as a low pressure gas and heads towards the compressor, which as we now know is going to compress the gas, increasing its pressure and temperature. This cycle is repeated over and over to ensure the correct temperature is maintained inside the refrigerator. I hope you all enjoyed this video, and don't forget to subscribe for more content like this. Thank you for watching. Mind Motion out.